We've got the all-new Toyota Tacoma iForce Max.
Is this hybrid right for you?
You ready? Feel the power of the iForce Max.
We're here for the hybrid. Andrea, what's under the hood of this thing?
A 2.4 liter turbocharged four cylinder with a hybrid powertrain. It has 326 combined horsepower and 465 pound feet of torque. That's a 75% increase in torque compared to the outgoing V6. This is the most powerful Tacoma ever made.
How this works for this hybrid, it is a 48 horsepower electric motor integrated into the 8-speed automatic transmission, and it uses a 1.87 kilowatt hour battery. You can use regular fuel in this hybrid. So they had a separate program to drive the regular gas model. We have a video on that. We also have a couple of videos with the chief engineer of Tacoma. So what I'm gonna do is I'll put them all in the description below. Have them look when you have a moment. Right now, what are the key standard features of this iForce Max?
The base trim comes with a 12.3-inch digital driver display, a 14-inch touchscreen, wireless Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, a head-up display, panoramic view monitor, a wireless charger, 2400-watt AC power outlet, a 10-speaker JBL audio system with a portable speaker, heated and ventilated front seats, Softex upholstery, a heated steering wheel, a moonroof, a power tailgate, and Toyota SafetySense 3.0. Since there is a more stripped down base model in the US, not all of these features are standard, but we'll talk about it a little bit later on in the video.
Oh yeah, we have all the different drive modes, you name it. This thing can do a lot. What are we gonna put it in?
Gotta put it in S for subscribing. If you can hit that notification bell, you'll be notified when all of our reviews drop and then you can watch them.
And we do this, the couple car review twice a week. The first one drops on Wednesday.
We put another one out on Saturday.
So make sure to like and subscribe, but also follow along on Instagram. It's Motormouth_Andrew to see what's up behind the scenes. For me, it's Motormouth_Auto and the links are below the like button. So no longer a V6. A lot of it is about fuel economy and emissions regulations. Manufacturers are downsizing engines. The base is now a turbo four, just like Ford with Ranger. But to get more power, they go to this hybrid system, and we've both had a chance to drive it. What I noticed right away, Andrea, is that instant toe-in throttle, you get that torque right away.
It's incredible. I mean, you will never find a lack of power unless maybe you're going up a super steep incline and you're towing something. This really is fantastic. I think even the steering on this, you know, it has a really good feel to it. We're in the limited model and the feedback is good. It's not too heavy, so it makes the Tacoma really easy to maneuver.
Yeah, so the limited is kind of like more of the road one you would want. It has more of an all-season tire than the all-terrain tires you get on some of the off-road models. So we had a long discussion with the chief engineer about, okay, so say you're going on a long grade, so up through a mountain pass and you're towing, say, a 5,000 pound trailer, that small battery, it's 1.87 kilowatt hours, it's gonna deplete quickly. And the way he explained it is there's always energy saved in the battery for extreme maneuvers. It always has a steady state. So you're not really, most of the time, utilizing the electric power. It's the turbo four that's doing most of the work. That's really to get you launched away, like say you're pulling a boat out of a boat ramp, something like that. And it's there when you need it. And the gasoline engine will create enough electricity to keep that battery topped up.
And that torque number, 465 pound-feet of torque, is huge. And it kicks in at 1700 RPM. So I think that unless you're towing very large items and you're doing things like steep inclines, I don't think you would buy Tacoma for that. And that's what Sheldon Brown said, the chief engineer. He said, then you're gonna buy something that has more towing capability, like the Tundra, which makes total sense.
Or you get a diesel Super Duty from Ford or something like that.
Yep.
So this is really a recreational truck for people who tow occasionally, and it's gonna be more than capable of doing that.
And even Sheldon said that they weren't gonna get into the towing race with other brands, that they were trying to produce a Tacoma that drives handles really well, and has the capability to tow, but maybe not as much as some of the others.
So we're kind of getting hung up on the towing, because that's something a truck has to do.
Yeah.
But the actual general drivability, which is what most people are using for every day, it's actually very good. And that's the one thing that we like about this new Tacoma over the old one. The seating position's better, it's better noise insulation. The old V6 was kind of droney. Yeah. The transmission was shifting and hunting for gears. This is way better on every score.
Yeah, the 8-speed automatic transmission shifts smoothly and quickly. You will really enjoy how this handles. Now, the iForce Max Hybrid powertrain isn't available on every model. In Canada, it's standard on the Trailhunter, TRD Pro, and Limited models, but it is an option on TRD Off-Road Premium. In the US, a little bit of a different story. Standard on TRD Pro and Trailhunter. Optional on TRD Sport, TRD Off-Road, and Limited models. Now, Tacoma, every model is different. It offers a different suspension and different shocks.
The Limited model has an adaptive variable suspension. Toyota hybrids come with part-time four-wheel drive and a 2-speed transfer case included. TRD Off-Road Premium, TRD Pro, and Trailhunter all come with part-time four-wheel drive with a 2-speed transfer case. These models also have an electronic locking differential, active traction control, and hill start assist. Now, if you want full-time four-wheel drive, that's the Limited model, and it also comes with a central locking differential.
All Tacomas come standard with drive mode select, so you can change the settings of the drive force, suspension, and the steering. A tow haul setting is standard on all hybrids. The Limited trim adds two more drive modes, Sport S Plus and Comfort Plus, a custom mode.
So a new feature for Tacoma is the new stabilizer disconnect mechanism, which is standard on Trailhunter and TRD Pro and available on the TRD Off-Road. It increases front suspension articulation at the push of a button. By the way, the TRD Pro also has a 2-inch lift. The Tacoma has a 35.7 degree approach angle and a 26.1 breakover and 26.1 degree departure angle. So you really have to know your Tacomas to know which one has the iForce Max. It's really mostly the badge on the side.
Yeah.
And it's been out for a while now. I think I like the looks of it.
I really like it too. It's rugged looking. It has this athletic stance to it. It has a slim body. And I think that Toyota...
Who doesn't like a slim body, Andrew?
We all like a slim body. Toyota did a really nice job with the redesign. I mean, it still looks like a Tacoma. Comes standard with LED headlights, LED taillights, LED fog lights. All hybrids get 18-inch wheels, but the TRD Pro and the Trailhunter models get 33-inch all-terrain tires.
So compared to the last Tacoma, the overall length is identical and the door-to-door width is identical. You get bigger, boxier looking fender flares. That's something that makes it a little wider because the track of this vehicle is wider than the last model.
And I think what's cool about it is that depending on the trim you get, the exterior design has different elements, whether it's the grill or the badging on the side, and that moves on into the interior as well.
Now, we spoke to Sheldon, the chief engineer, a lot. He's such a great guy, easy to talk to.
Knows his stuff.
And we were talking about 4Runner, and 4Runner is based on this. So from this pillar forward was engineered and designed mostly by the crew that was in charge of Tacoma, and the back half they had to obviously make separate for 4Runner. And when you look at the front of this, it's the same, and it's not bad because it's well laid out.
And the comfort level in here has just improved so much. What a difference. I couldn't get comfortable in the old Tacoma. I know many of you feel that way as well. I really like the seat comfort in here.
So what they did was they raised the seating position by 30 millimeters. That's just over 2.5 inches. And to compensate for that, they made the vehicle taller by 30 millimeters. So you have a higher seating position and your knees and your legs aren't sticking straight out. You now have a bit of an angle, and that really relieves pressure on your lower back. It was a complaint, big complaint of the old one, solved now.
Oh, I mean, I drove the old one and my hips would hurt when I got out of it, and I don't have hip problems.
I do.
So he does. So that pitch just wasn't great. Much improved. I like the interior layout in here. It has a truck-like feel. I mean, there is a mix of soft materials and hard plastic. You've got a traditional shifter. There's plenty of storage. And in Canada, you get the larger screens. In the US, you have more trims available, so you have a standard 8-inch touchscreen on that base model. Also a difference between Canada and the U.S. This comes
standard with Canada.
It is colder. Well, some parts of the U.S. get pretty cold. This comes standard with Softec seats, but in the U.S. it's fabric.
Okay, so one kind of cool thing is if you get the TRD Pro, that's sort of the Baja racer looking one, you also get the shock absorber seats that you can pump up to different pressures depending on what kind of attitude and weight you are for going rock crawling and that kind of thing. I think it's a bit gimmicky myself, but some people are really hot on those seats.
And when I asked Sheldon about TRD Pro, because it just has such a huge following, and now Trailhunter is new to Tacoma, which ones do you think people will buy? He says, look, there's always going to be people who love TRD Pro. But Trailhunter does a little bit more. Yeah. They've got a design that you can build it your own way. All the accessories. You want to put a rooftop tent. You can do that with TRD Pro, but I guess they've set it up with Trailhunter that it's a little bit easier to do it. And he said it's like the adventure-ready person for Trailhunter.
Yeah, the other thing is there's a whole group of people with pickup trucks that just want the best. They just want to spend and say, okay, what's the most expensive one? That's the one I want, because they've just got the money and they like to flex with their truck. I get that. When we get to the price, oh, we've already got our seatbelt on. Mid-sized trucks are getting very expensive. And that's one of the complaints, Andrea, is that the economy, entry-level, cheap and cheerful mid-sized pickup truck is no longer. It doesn't exist from any brand.
No, and Trailhunter certainly gets up there on price, but it is cool looking.
Lots of different grades in the hybrid. Depending on what trim you get anywhere from 9.5 to 11.5 inches of ground clearance. Obviously, the ones that are lifted by 2 inches, they get 2 inches more ground clearance. Now, if you want a 6-foot bed, most of them are sold with the regular gas model. There is one exception. It's the Trailhunter as a 6-foot bed. All of these other iForce Max, just 5-foot beds.
Now, in the U.S., it's a little different. The Trailhunter has the option of a 5-foot and a 6-foot bed.
And speaking of the bed is still a composite bed. However, it is lighter than the old bed, which is helping with fuel efficiency. And a nice new feature is a power operated tailgate available, but it does have a dampened opening feature, which makes it not slam down.
Yeah. Now, this is based on the TNGAF platform, and it uses a fully box frame.
Well, we were recently on the Ford Ranger program. We drove the regular Ranger, the Ranger Raptor. They did a really good job with those trucks. Ford knows how to make a truck as well. One area that this doesn't hold a candle to when it comes to the Ford Ranger is rear seat legroom. The Ranger just has more room, yeah, and I think a more comfortable pitch to the seats, and it's just a more comfortable place to spend time back there. That's still, pardon the pun, Andrea, a shortcoming of the Tacoma is the legroom.
Comparing the Tacoma to the Ford Ranger, it offers 41.8 inches of front row legroom, which is almost 2 inches less than the Ford. Second row legroom at 33.7 inches falls short as well to the Ranger by almost an inch. I also want to add that for the hybrid, there is only a 4-door double cap configuration.
All right, let's get into fuel economy, the price, and we already mentioned the seatbelts on, in our vital stats.
Let's start with pricing. We'll do Canada first and then move on to the U.S. This is MSRP. The limited model with the 5-foot bed starts at just over $63,000. The Trailhunter with a 6-foot bed is just under $83,000. In the U.S., the TRD Sport is the base model and it starts at just over $46,000. And the TRD Pro 5-foot bed is your highest price Tacoma at just under $64,000.
Now, fuel economy does vary depend on trim and equipment. We've got a combined fuel economy average, which is 10.2 liters combined city and highway per 100 kilometers. That's 24 miles per gallon combined. Towing capacity is 6,400 pounds and the payload 1,700 pounds. The warranty is 3 years, 60,000 kilometers or 36,000 miles. In the United States, complimentary scheduled maintenance is offered for 2 years or 25,000 miles. Well, mid-sized trucks, what else can you buy?
For your consideration, four vehicles for you to consider.
Up first is the Ford Ranger Raptor with a 3-liter EcoBoost V6, 405 horsepower and a starting price over $80,000.
The Chevrolet Colorado ZR2 with a 2.7-liter high-output turbocharged four-cylinder. 310 horsepower, and a starting price of almost 61 grand.
The GMC Canyon AT4X with the same powertrain as the Colorado ZR2, but a starting price of almost $70,000.
The Jeep Gladiator Rubicon with a 3.6-liter Pentastar V6, 285 horsepower, and a starting price over $60,000.
So there are four pickup trucks for you to consider.
Lightning round, two things we like to see improved.
I really love the exterior design of Tacoma.
The added power is almost instantaneous.
And I would love it if the rear seat was just a little bit more comfortable.
And I just wish they had the 6-foot bed option available on all Tacomas, not just select ones. So that's the Tacoma iForce Max Hybrid. What do you think of that?
If you like what you see, subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.